Hi, my name is Lee Klontz, and I'm a web developer in Atlanta, Georgia. In this video, we're going to use jQuery and jQuery UI to transform a simple registration form into something more usable, functional, and attractive. We'll use a few simple techniques to create tab sections that work great with mouse, keyboard, or touch. We'll learn how to create a color scheme that can coordinate look and feel across multiple tabs and widgets, and we'll require a user agreement to be checked before the form can be submitted. Now, even though we're using a form as an example, the techniques are useful anywhere you have content that you want to present in bite-sized chunks. Technically, all you'll need is a basic functional knowledge of HTML, and some comfort with JavaScript syntax would be useful, but I'll tell you all you need to know in the video. So let's get started. So we're going to start with a very basic registration form. You've certainly seen forms like this 1,000 times. This one doesn't have any real style or functionality. It's just asking basic demographic information. It asks you to subscribe to some newsletters. There's some legalese down here. This is just fake filler text to show you how you could deal with a terms and conditions style agreement. At the bottom, there is a checkbox to have you agree to the terms and conditions, as well as a submit button. So what we're going to be working toward is turning it into this. This is a tabbed form. You can see it has all the same information, but it's in a much more consumable, much more attractive format, and it works with keyboard, works with touch. You can use shortcuts. It requires that the terms and conditions be agreed to before the submit button will actually light and function, and you can see it toggles on and off. We have the jQuery library included here, and this is pulling it from the jQuery Content Delivery Network, or CDN, at jQuery.com. So I'm going to paste the jQuery and jQuery UI libraries into the head, and that's going to enable the functionality on our page. Now, nothing's actually going to look any different. We've just included the libraries, which have activated the functionality, but we're not actually using it yet. The other thing we want to do is grab a theme, and those are available at jQueryUI.com, or user interface. And if you go to that site, go to the themes link, you'll see a theme roller on the left. And what that will let you do is browse the gallery of existing themes, and you can see what they'll look like and what the different widgets will look like on your page. They all have a name. You can see Redmond, you can see Sunny. Those are typically going to be available on the major CDNs, the content delivery networks, just like the libraries are. So if you want to pull those remotely, you can do so. Or you can roll your own theme, a completely custom version, where you'll have to download the CSS manually and include it on your site. You can play with the themes in real time and see the differences, and when you're satisfied with it, you can download it to your local site and include it. So in my case, I'm going to use a CDN theme, right? I'm going to use Cupertino. The names all fit into the same naming convention where the name goes in between the themes and the CSS document itself. So when I save that in a preview, nothing will actually have happened yet because we haven't started invoking any of the jQuery functionality yet, but we're going to do that now. So the next thing we're going to do is wrap the entire form in an ID'd div. I'm going to make one called tabbed form and put the close div tag at the bottom. And what that's going to do is let me use jQuery to identify where my content is actually going to be, my tabbed content. The next thing we need to do is to break the content within this main div, this tab form div, into individual sections by using named div tags. I'm going to create one for the personal info. I'm going to create one for contact info, one for subscribe, and one for terms. Each of these divs is going to map to a tab, so you want to make sure that you ID them as something memorable, because in a moment we're going to map those IDs to the tabs that will point to them. So I'm going to come up to the top and I'm going to create an ordered list with four LIs. And these will map to our four tabs. So the links that will be inside the LIs will map to the IDs of the tabs that we're going to create. So I have personal, and I'm going to map that to something called personal info. Contact info is going to map to an anchor called contact. Subscribe is going to map to an anchor called subscribe. And terms is going to map to an anchor called terms. When I come back out, this will just look like a regular old ordered list. So now we're actually going to do some jQuery. So making sure that the document has the library included at the top, I'm going to create a script tag, a JavaScript tag. And what I'm going to do in that tag is put a dollar sign. And the dollar sign is a symbol used to identify to the JavaScript parser that we're going to start working with a jQuery method. And if jQuery is included, this will all happen automatically. So I'm going to create a function. And what I want to occur when that function runs is that it's going to find the ID element of tabbed form. It's going to run a function called tabs, which is enabled by the jQuery UI library. So as long as the ID that you've identified in this function is the same as the one that you have identified in your div, when you reload, we should have tabs. And you can see here that we do. Just by doing that one command, the tabs have been created. They're using the theme that we have included. The Cupertino theme gives us this blue and light blue color combination, but it'll use whichever one you chose. By default, the tabs will take up the entire width of the document or whatever element you have them contained within. Since it's 100% right now, that's what it's taking up. It'll conform to any CSS you attach to that tab form div, that containing div. So I'm going to make a style tag. We're going to go ahead and make the font a little smaller and make the width a little narrower. So I'll say tab form should be a width of 700 pixels, and we'll make the font size smaller relative to the document. And then I'll make everything look a little bit more like what I want it to look like. In this case, yours can look like whatever you like. So next we want to make this terms checkbox toggle the submit button. Right now that doesn't work, but we'll change that shortly. So we go back into our HTML. We have a checkbox ID'd as agreement, and we have a submit button ID'd as submit button, and it's currently set to be disabled. So I'm going to come up to the top. I'm going to create a new function either in the existing script block or in a new one. It doesn't actually matter. However you like to organize your document is fine. So the first thing we need to do is override the default behavior of buttons. Basically tell the HTML renderer, the browser, that we're going to control how this button gets fired. So we're going to create a function. And we're going to attach it to button objects. And we're going to run a button method and the click method of that object. And so what we're going to do is say, basically, anytime there's a click, run an event called prevent default, which will prevent the default action of that button. We'll need to make sure we write a JavaScript function in order to process that submit button. But that just works like normal, any normal JavaScript would. So next, we're going to tell we're going to write a function to tell checkbox what to do when we check it. So we're going to make a new function, making sure it ends with a semicolon. And what we're going to say is bind it to the agreement ID'd object. And we're going to attach to the click method. And so that is a checkbox. And we are going to run a function when that object is clicked, when that checkbox is clicked. And we're going to say, when the click is fired, if this element is checked, then we want to set the button called submit button. Remember, it's ID'd as submit button in my case. And we want to run the button method of that object, enable. Otherwise, So if it's unchecked, we want to do the opposite and check the submit button to disable. So everything should now match up. So we start a function. It's working on the ID'd object agreement, the click method, and then if it's checked, then we want to enable it. And if it's not checked, if it's being unchecked, we want to disable it. So let's take a look. We reload, we go to terms, now it's disabled. When we check the box, it's enabled. When we uncheck it, it's disabled. Everything works the way it's supposed to. So the last thing we want to do is make the form a little easier to follow by making next buttons at the bottom of the first, second, and third tabs. That'll take you through kind of a stepwise process through the form. So at the bottom of each of our divs, we want to create a paragraph container with a button inside, and we want to call this one, we're going to ID this one as next button one. We'll put the text that will appear inside of it, and we'll save. And when we come out and reload, we'll see the jQuery UI has made the button's appearance fit into the broader look and feel of the Cupertino scheme, right? The Cupertino UI theme. Everything looks like it's part of a unified whole, which is one of the nice things about jQuery UI. So next we want to come in, we want to copy that button and paste it into each of our divs. And we'll number them as 1, 2, and 3, mapping to whichever tab they're in. So when I reload, now each tabbed region should have a next button. They don't do anything yet, but we're gonna put that JavaScript in now. So what we wanna do is trap for when a user clicks on each of these individual buttons. You could do this programmatically, but I'm gonna do them one by one just to make it a little easier to follow. So we wanna create a function, and we want to say, we want to attach to the next button one ID object. We'll go into the button method and the click method of the button. And we want to run a function when that button is clicked on. And what we want it to do is within the tab form element and the tabs method, we're going to change option active to 1. So remembering that JavaScript numbers from 0, these tabs are actually 0, 1, and 2 within the JavaScript construct. So when we say go to active tab 1, we're actually going to the second tab. So now when we come out and reload and we click on the next button, it takes us to the second. So just to show you how this works again, we're going to duplicate this function a couple of times and basically just make it work for button 2 and take you to tab 2. And then 3 to tab 3. We'll come out now and confirm that everything works as it's supposed to, and it does. The checkbox still works as well. Now this is purely for interface. There's no submission handler here. Really what this exercise is about is taking a cumbersome, lengthy piece of content and breaking it into chunks to make it more easily consumable for your users. So that's a taste of the power of jQuery and jQuery UI, but there's plenty more from here. I encourage you to visit the API documentation at the jQuery homepages or view other videos to learn more. Good luck with your development, and I look forward to your feedback.